Hey guys, this will be a guide for efficient crafting in Faria. I personally didn't go free to play because I wanted all the cards from the beginning to try the different decks. But I have some experience from other card games which should be helpful here. And if you enjoy the grinding or simply don't want to spend any money, that's definitely viable. And from my experience should be much faster than in other CCGs. First I will give you some general tips on the crafting, and later I will do some kind of tier list for the top cards that are worth for you to craft. So here you can find the crafting menu. You see for every card there are standard versions and mythic versions, which are 5 times as expensive and give you 5 times as much memoria to craft. There are the 4 rarities, and they start with 1 for disenchanting, 5 to craft, and the amount goes up by 4 times each, so it's 5 and 20, 20 and 80, and then 80 and 320. Beware that if you click the disenchant button, there's no confirmation, so it will get disenchanted right away. And you can also click this button here to disenchant all excess memoria for cards that you have duplicates from. So that's it for the menu. You see there are like, this is your resource for crafting, which is very important, but there's also another thing that's important to get the full collection or as many cards as possible, which is your gold, and like some tips on how to get them. Of course, through leveling up, so level 30 is the maximum level. Then through doing all the solo content, which are the puzzles and the quests. And of course you should also always do your daily quests, of which you can have up to 3 at once. And the most important thing are the Pandora runs. So you get 1 Phantom coin for free each day. And if you do them, and I think you get to 6 wins, or maybe also with 5, you can get the Pandora coin as reward, and I think some other stuff as well. But the most important thing are the Pandora runs, because if you finish a Pandora run, you get the pack, you get some gold, some memoria, and a mythic card, which is very worth to disenchant, because when you go to 9, up to between 9 and 12 wins, you can get the legendary or just the epic mythic card, which is worth a lot and helps you to get enough resources to craft. And also for going infinite, it should be about 7 average wins in Pandora runs, which should allow you to easily go infinite. And yeah, the next topic is, what is actually your goal with crafting? So do you want to go for the full collection? Then it's best to simply wait and never craft until you can actually craft every card in the game, if that's really your plan. If you just want to go for one deck and focus more on ladder from right away because you don't like Pandora, you should start with the most expensive cards first. Let's say get your legendaries, then the epics, and if by the time you maybe need some rares still, you can also get them and then simply grind the ladder with it. I would personally suggest some middle ground between these methods, and for that I will give you some tips now. So like mentioned before, the longer you wait, the more you get out of your crafting, simply because of the fact that if you get duplicates from packs where you already crafted the card. So just as example, you want to play mono blue, and you, oh, where's the crafting? You want to play mono blue and you craft Mirror Phantasms, and later on get Mirror Phantasms from a pack. You spend 80 and only get 20 back for the disenchant. So you should rather hold back with crafting and see what you get from packs first. However, like also mentioned before, if you ever want to spend some crafting, do it for legendaries and epics, because they are rare anyway, and the lower rarities you will get through having enough packs. So it's very likely just after a couple of weeks, or if you play a lot of days, you will have most of them. And then another trick for epics or rares, if you want to craft them, is that you only go for two copies. So let's say you want Mirror Phantasms and you have zero, you can craft two, but maybe you get the third one from a pack, so that you don't have this waste of 60 memoria here when you craft them and have to disenchant them later. And another reason why it's worth to keep holding on your cards and craft as late as possible is if there's a balance patch. That means if a card gets nerfed, you get the full refund. So let's say you have 4 Mirror Phantasms and don't need the memorial right now from disenchanting. You just wait and the card might get nerfed, and then you will get 80 back instead of 20. So the next thing will be the top tier legendaries, which I would recommend you to craft, and you will probably never regret. For blue, that's Mythmaker, Aurora's Mythmaker. This is tier 1 for legendaries for blue. For red, it's Garrodon, the legendary dragon. And for yellow, it's Kalim, Sky Prodigy. These are the three top tier legendaries, and you should not regret having crafted. Tier 2 would be Beru and Tetra in my eyes. These two are in some decks okay, and if you have enough memoria, also worth to craft. Other legendaries I would not recommend you to craft. For epics, these are more some deck enabling epics like Earthcraft. This is very versatile and can be used in more the combo heavier decks. Stuff like Apex or Wish, you basically need them. So it's not a bad call to go for Earthcraft. Unbound Evolution, which is one of the strongest blue cards, or strongest cards in the game at all. Then of course the Mirror Phantasm, also a very powerful card. For red it would be Groundshaker and Bombslinger. You could consider Fire, Flame Burst I mean, but that's there are some other cards that do the same. It's only really needed for a burn deck in my eyes. And out of the yellow cards, I would say Prayer is needed for rush decks, and then the Champion for control or slower yellow tempo, I mean a bit more faster yellow tempo decks. As for rares, probably the best ways to spend your memoria are for yellow Last Nightmare. For red it would be Axe Grinders. For blue I would say Battletoads, and for green it's definitely the Whirlwind Force, especially if you start out with a green deck. That's a very powerful card. And then simply a last tip If you want to spend a little bit of money only, the best way to do it is the gold fountain, which should be in total 2400 gold, which is equal to 24 packs for only 5 euro, compared to like all these other options, which are definitely more expensive, but you also have to wait a bit of time until you get the full value. So that's actually it for now. If you have any questions, you can ask me in comments. In the comments, I can also give you some tips on specific cards if you ask me, should I craft them for this deck? And yeah, thanks for tuning in. Bye bye.